Hello and welcome to tonight's special presentation of the 2008 South Australian Sprint Car Championship, coming to you from Speedway City. Tonight is part one of a two-part special, so please sit back and enjoy the heat racing from the 2008 South Aussie Sprint Car Champs. In the race car ready to go, Darryl Wright, welcome back to Speedway City.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
And state title, you finished second in the past, we're looking to go one better tonight.
Yeah, actually last year I think we damaged the motor at it when we was running second, so tonight we're looking to go one better and finish the race and hopefully be there at the end.
Now you've already had a race victory this season as this race team with Darren Baker in the car, so you've got a lot to live up to.
Mate, I've been struggling and it's bad when your crew chief can win one and you can't.
But of course you travel from Murray Bridge each meeting here at Speedway City. What do you think of this racetrack?
Yeah, it's our first time down here this year with the 360 myself, so we don't mind coming down here as long as it's not too hot and dry and dusty.
Oh, well, all the best. We'll let you go. I know you're going to have a big night ahead of you. All the best.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
So the first heat on tonight on the infield program, we'll see the 360 giving it sprint car Victorian David Cook and Renmark resident Chris Evans on the front row, and we're racing here into turn number 1 and 2. And on the top side of Speedway in car number 28 is Darryl Wright, who scorches to the race lead. Down the back shooting to turn number 3 and 4, Darryl Wright, the Murray Bridge driver. Leading the pack, second is Chris Evans, third is David Cook. There's Josh Ruse at a broken hill in the bright yellow race car. There's a good stoush. Further back in the pack, the defending South Aussie champion, Clinton Oliver, in car number 66. In a roundabout fifth spot, as we see now, Darryl Guerin up into third, but have a look, David Cook now fighting back on the inside. Good racing here for third and fourth for the South Aussie or the Broken Hill resident. Darryl Guerin will get the best of the Victorian as they scorch down the back chute in front of this great crowd in the house here this evening. Out of turn number 4. One of the cars very high indeed in turn number 4. There's Clinton Oliver in car number 66. There's a 99 of Josh Ruse just behind the number 25 machine out of Lang in Victoria, David Cook. Our leader is still Darryl Wright in car number 28, the driver we met earlier. Darryl Guerin in the 96. Back there in the third spot holding out David Cook. As we look further back in the pack, a car spinning there. One of the Brennan boys out of Mildura in car number 79. I think it may have been Gary Brennan. Have a look at David Cook, very untidy there in turn number 2. In fact, the Josh Ruse machine may have just picked the front end of the 25. As we see now, the 99 of Jason McIver out of Darwin moving up also. David Cook all over the racetrack here in hit number 1. In car number 25. Darryl Wright about to put him a lap down. As we look further back there, there's Clinton Oliver once again. And have a look at the car almost in the wall up there. It's a 99 of Jason McIver. In fact, we've got a car spun down there. David Cook almost coming to grief. Another car right in behind him. So on the restart, it'll be Darryl Wright in car number 28. Followed by the 77 of Chris Evans. And we go back to the 66 of Clinton Oliver, Jason McIver in car 99. As they charge down the back chute, Darryl Guerin on the infield, unfortunate for the driver out of Broken Hill. As they scorch down through turn number 1 and 2 past, the George Catton will stand in turn 2. David Cook once again all untidy there in turn number 2, having his first drive here at Speedway City, the former Super Rod driver. But down through turn number 1 and 2, a good stoush developing there between Clinton Oliver and the 99 of Jason McIver, who finished third in the last start here at Speedway City. But the checkered flag comes out for Darryl Wright. Second across line will be Chris Evans with Clinton Oliver in third. Mark, you've already won a feature race this year, so how are you going into tonight?
Yeah, learning every race meeting here, I suppose, with the 410s, and try a few more things tonight, but it should be all right.
And how are you finding the 410s? You're the first South Australian ever to win a 410 feature race, actually.
Yeah, it's taken a bit longer than we first expected, sort of to get the hang of it, but slowly getting the gearing worked out and the setup's worked out, so it's not looking too bad.
And the cars here tonight, this local, the domestic field's pretty good here.
Oh, yeah, tonight, I mean, if you can get into the top 5, you're doing pretty good, I reckon.
Is there any particular drivers that you're really looking out for? Of course, Jason Johnson making an appearance here tonight too.
Yeah, he'll be hard to beat, and so will Stephen Lyons and Phil March. You know, there's a number of guys here that can actually win it tonight.
So all the best for tonight, and we know you're pretty busy. We're about to go for Heat 1, but good luck.
Yeah, thanks.
So the driver we just spoke to, Mark Reuter, here to go on the front row alongside the 82 of Lee Dillon. Heat one of the 410, giving it Sprint Car State Championship, we're green. Into turn number one, it's doing Mark Reuter, who got the best of the jump. Lee Dillon slots into second, Phil March, the 1999 Australian Sprint Car Champion and former South Aussie Champion, back there in the third spot. One lap down, nine remaining here, as we look further back. Jamie Stark getting past there in the 72 by the 97 of Jamie Colby tonight. Colby making a guest appearance in the Downing Brothers machine. The leader is Mark Reuter, second is Lee Dillon, Phil March, then it's Jamie Colby. Jamie Stark in kind of the 72, in behind him is the 25 of Justin Sloan out of Williamstown. Then we go back to Trevor Green in car number 17. John Green binding this evening. He should be racing up in Sydney, but Hugo Rainout is here tonight in a guest appearance in the 17 Snee. As they go down through turn number one and two, Jamie Stark doing a fine job. Only second season of sprint car racing. Out of Port McDonald, down near Mount Gambier. Out of turn four, have a look at Trevor Green in the 17 machine, trying to work the high side. Jamie Cobby coming into play here. Not too far off the back of the number three machine of Phil March. As they go through turn number three and four, Trevor Green with a big move on the outside of Justin Sloan. And he'll take over a position. Next car to go past. The next car for Trevor Green on the shopping list will be the 72 of Jamie Stark. And there he goes up the inside. So Trevor Green on a charge here. Started dead last in the field. He's up into around about fifth position. As they go down through turn number two, there's Justin Sloan in car 25. Down through turn number three and four. In behind him is Dylan Jenkins in car number 51 out of Bordertown. But our leader, out of Findon right here in Adelaide, is Mark Reuter. Have a look at Jamie Cobby. Right up against the boards in turn four. Lee Dillon doing a fine job, the former Australian former champion. Phil March in the third spot. Jamie Cobby, having his first drive in this race car, hadn't sat in it before the hot laps here tonight, and he is putting on a show here back there in four. Pressuring one of Australia's best sprint car drivers in March. Our leaders are catching up to the back markers here. Checkered flag will be up for Mark Reuter, second to Lee Dillon, third to Phil March. Then we go back to Jamie Cobby, and just coming across the line now, Trevor.
You're welcome to Distance to the Field in the 360 state title tonight is Victorian Lauren Densley. Lauren, welcome to Speedway City.
Thanks very much, I'm happy to be here. We haven't seen Adelaide before, so it should be a good night.
And I suppose you get the token question, what's it like to be a female out there? But you're just another car out there, aren't you?
That's it. It's no different. You put your helmet on, it doesn't matter what you look like underneath it. So we're just here to race and hopefully we'll do all right.
And for those of guys out there that don't know much about you, what have you been doing in the past?
We ran the 360s, obviously, beginning of this season. We ran them last year. It was our first year and we came on and had some pretty good racing. So hopefully this year we can pick up. We've got a new car owner this year. We're working with Dan Morton and the Moorvale Group. So we've got his car from last year and a 360 motor that he's given us, so hopefully we can have some good results and, you know, get used to the track. We've come over here and we'll do Murray Bridge next weekend to get ready for the Australian title, and with any luck we'll pull together some good meetings.
So you haven't raced too much against too many of these South Aussie drivers. What do you know about them?
Oh, we've seen a few of them come over for a few shows, but no, there's a fair few new guys, but I mean, we'll see what happens. It's all just another race car out there.
Oh, well, thanks for joining us tonight, and we'll keep an eye on the Victoria 55 and hope you have a good night.
No worries, glad to be here.
So the 360 giving it sprint cars, heat race number two on the speedway. Out of turn four, we're racing into turn number one and two, and it's Terry Pitt in car number 87, the 17-year-old who lead them down the back straight. Hustle and bustle further back in the pack, good racing out of turn number two. The leader is Terry Pitt in the 87. Charging his way forward now is Jamie Colby in car 67. He's doing double duty here tonight. Have a look at Harold Brennan Jr. Back up the inside on the 79. Good side-by-side racing here for second and third. But the Mildura driver will take over the second spot. Harold Brennan Jr. We go back to Jamie Colby. Then we go back to Lauren Densley in car number 55. Further back also is Jamie Hendry in the 42. Here comes American Jason Johnson with a slide job on the inside of Lauren Densley. The American Johnson, you also see him racing 410s as well. Double duty for him as well. As he charges down the back straight, the Louisiana pilot took out four World Series feature race wins on the trot this season in Australia's toughest sprint car competition. But have a look at Terry Pitt, the 17-year-old in the Triple X chassis. Leading the pack here, Harold Brennan Jr. in the second spot. And we go back to Jamie Cobby. This is a good heat race. As they charge into 1 and 2, here comes Johnson as well in car 5. We're about to have a 4-car shootout for the race lead. It's Terry Pitt in the 87. Here comes Harold Brennan Jr. Up the inside, a new race leader. What can Cobby do as he looks to the outside now of Terry Pitt through turn number 1 and 2, and he gets the move. So Pitt's gone from first to third in a matter of a lap. The next car, looking at the back of Terry Pitt, is the American, Jason Johnson. So it's the Victorian out of Mildura, Harold Brennan Jr. Has finished third in the state title a couple of years ago. Have a look now at Johnson applying the blowtorch now to Terry Pitt, but Pitt shut the door in turn number 3. Good racing, he held to his guns there as they head down the back chute. The car had got a lap down. This is a 37 of Terry Kelly, another Mildura driver. Checkered flag not too far away here for Harold Brennan Jr. Cobby is second, Pitt is third, Johnson is fourth in car number 5 as they go down through 3 and 4. Out of the sunlight and into the shade. The checkered flag will wave this time for Harold Brennan Jr. Cobby second. Third will go to Terry Pitt. Jason Johnson, the American, in 4. Into turn number 1 and 2, and it's Stephen Lyons in car number 45 who'll lead them down the back chute. The Mount Gambier driver in the second spot is the 21 of Craig Vanderstelt, the American Jason Johnson. Back there in the third spot. And they're back to Glenn Sutherland in car number 20, but have a look at the lead. That Stephen Lyons has already opened up. He's a former Australian street stock champion. He really has become one of South Australia's best sprint car pilots over the last year or so. Can he hold on here for the opening heat of the night? Vanderstelt back there in position number 2 in a smartly turned out number 21. And it's Jason Johnson in car number 5 driving for Darren Disbury, the Angle Vale car owner, down through turn number 2. Disbury has had Jason Johnson in his car for about the last 4 seasons, and Jason Johnson really has become one of South Australia's adopted drivers here, despite the fact that he has US citizenship. Down the back chute, Johnson has got no answer for Craig Vanderstelt at the moment. And Vanderstelt likewise, no answer for the race leader. Have a look at the wheel stand there from Jason Johnson in turn number 4. Got on the gas and the front wheels came up in the air. Spectacular stuff from the 410 cubic inch sprint cars. One of the cars about to go a lap down, debutant Daniel Pesky. Oh, got a car upside down in turn number 3. It's the 20 of Glenn Sutherland to the top of your picture. That's a big ride in turn number 3. I think the other car involved is Matt Eagle in car number 29. If you look at the second angle we've got, top of the picture, and the top wing, or part of the top wing, has gone over the fence. That is a really big crash from Glenn Sutherland, the big Mount Gambier driver. Stands well and truly over 6 foot. And that was a nasty ride. So on the restart, it'll be the 45. A fellow Mount Gambier resident, Stephen Lyons, to lead them in. Vanderstelt second. Jason Johnson back there in the third spot. You can see the sun starting to set now. Here at Speedway City, heat number 2 of the 410 cubic inch sprint cars. Back there in the fourth spot is car number 7 of Jason Loveday. And then the only car left in the field is the 27 of Daniel Pesca, the 16-year-old out of Strathalbyn, having his first ever drive in a sprint car. Have a look now at Johnson, dive to the inside. Past Vanderstelt there in turn number 2. A great move from the American. Now into second, can he run down the 45 of Stephen Lyons before the laps run out? I don't think so. There's not too many laps remaining here in heat number 2 of the 410. Out of turn 4 there, Johnson smartly turned out. Black race car. There's the 45 of Stephen Lyons, the South Aussie, driving for a Victorian car owner, Dave Challens. Out of turn number 4, checkered flag away this time for Stephen Lyons. Johnson second, Vanderstelt third. Then we go back to Jason Loveday, the 27 of Daniel Pesca. to the 360, giving it Sprint Cars heat race number 3. This heat will complete the first round of heat races here in the state title. We're racing into turn number 1 to Jake. Ryan Jones got a great start in car number 63. He'll lead them down the back chute. Victorian Ashley Burke in the second spot in car number 23. And it's Stephen Caruso in car number 10. That's the 83 there of Shannon Barry. Smartly turned out race car, the one of Shannon Barry's. As we look now at the number 10 of Stephen Caruso. He has won 3 Sprint Car Feature Race wins on the trot here at Speedway City during the track championship. Looking for the big one here tonight. The South Aussie Championship coming to you exclusively tonight on the infield. Through turn number 3 and 4. Have a look at Ashley Burke in car number 23. Caruso trying to work him over in car number 10. Last year's South Australian Sprint Car Rookie of the Year. Fourth spot. As we look further back, is still the 83 of Shannon Barry. Finished third in this state title event last year. Down the back shoot is still Ryan Jones in car number 63 out of Murray Bridge. In the smartly turned out Triple X chassis, there's our leader. A nice tight in shot there as he headed down the front shoot and down through 1 and 2. Has real one of the big improvers this season as Ryan Jones finished third in last year's Speedway City Track Championship. Well and truly up there in the point score this season. There's Ashley Burke having his first look at Speedway City, the Victorian out of Warrnambool. Down the back chute into turn number 3 and 4. Oh, the car got very tight, but big push there in the middle of turn 3 and 4. But Stephen Caruso unable to capitalise on it. Shannon Barry just sitting back here in a very lonely fourth at the moment as they charge down the back chute path. The packed family stand on the back straight away. Caruso still in the third spot. Ashley Burke doing a fine job in the second spot, but no one's catching Ryan Jones at the moment as we have a look at Burke. At work behind the wheel in the 23. Ryan Jones is just skipping away with the win here. Down the back chute. Into turn number 3 and 4. Jonesy doing it nicely. Out of turn number 4. Checkered flag away for Ryan Jones. Ashley Burke will take second. Caruso third. Shannon Barry in the fourth spot. Just ahead of one of the Burfords. Four 10 cubic Sprint Cars heat race number 3. Dylan Jenkin on the front row in car number 51. Alongside him, last start feature race winner Matt Eagle in the 29. And it's Phil March, the 7 of Jason Loveday, Mark Reuter, and the 45 of Stephen Lyons. We're racing 10 laps on the counter as they go through turn number 1 and 2. It'll be Matt Eagle on the high side who will lead them down the back chute into turn number 3 and 4. This exciting second season racer, 23 years of age, down the back chute. As I mentioned, last start feature race winner in the Speedway City Track Championship. In behind him is Dylan Jenkin in car 51, former Australian Sprint Car Rookie of the Year. Down through turn number 1 and 2, Phil March on the inside. March couldn't quite get the job done that time. Phil March, one of the most exciting sprint car drivers in the country. Quietly spoken outside the race car, but when you put the helmet on, he is a hard-charging driver in that number 3. Reuter back there in the fourth spot, an earlier heat race winner. March now to the inside of Jenkin in turn number 3 and gets the move. So March to second, Jenkin back to third. We go back to Reuter and the 45 of Stephen Lyons trying to work over the 95 of Reuter. In fact, Lyons very high indeed in turn 2. Drop back quite a few car lengths as we look at now the 95 of Reuter trying to put the move on the 51 of Dylan Jenkin down in turn number 1, and Reuter's got the move in turn 2. Good stuff there from Reuter. He'll be looking pretty good in the points here, as too with the 45 of Stephen Lyons through turn number 1 and 2. As you can see, the floodlights well and truly taking effect here at Speedway City here in Virginia, South Australia's premier speedway venue. Out of turn number 4 past the pit gate. Can Stephen Lyons put the move on Mark Reuter as they come out of turn number 2? Down the back straight away. Into turn number 3 and 4. Reuter, of course, a multiple South Australian point score champion. Lyons to the inside, he'll get the move in turn 1. So Stephen Lyons on a charge here. in the smartly turned out J&J. He won't catch Matt Eagle or Phil Marsh, but he'll definitely record 30 if he can just hang on a lap or so out of turn number four. Our leader in the 29 is Matt Eagle. He'll take the win. Second will go to Phil Marsh, and third across the line will be Stephen Lyons. Mark Reuter fourth, and in behind him will be the seven of Jason Loveday. The journey here in heat number four of the 360 keeping its South Australian sprint car title. And leading them away in car number nine, it's Michael Burford. Down the back shoot, Jamie Hendry, the Lewiston driver. Back there in the second spot as they come out of turn number four to record lap one of 10. In the third spot is the 67 of Jamie Cobbett, in the 10 of Stephen Caruso. Down the back shoot, our leader is Michael Burford, finished second in the state title event last year, the current Speedway City track champion. Down past the Kimber Knighton and George Tattnall stands in one and two. Down the back shoot. Car's pretty strong out here. The only close battle at the moment is for second between Hendry and Cobby. Further back is the number 10 of Stephen Caruso. Down the back straightaway, there's the 79 of Harold Brennan Jr. battling it out with Victorian Phil Locke in car number four. Very distinctive race car, that of Phil Locke, with the big orange centre plane on the top wing. Hendry still in the second spot in car number 42. Smartly turned out Hendry Motorsports machine, the Maxim. In behind him, another Maxim driver in car number 67. It's Jamie Cobby. Then we go back to the 10 of Stephen Caruso. Good racing here for second, third and fourth. Hendry, can he hang on in his third season of sprint car racing? Finishing the top three in the state points championship last year. Through turn number one and two, there's Cobby driving for the Ray Bartlett, number 67. Caruso still sitting back there in the fourth spot. Can't really do anything about Jamie Cobby at the moment. And Cobby about the same distance back from Jamie Hendry, but our leader is Michael Burford. He is driving away with it in car number nine. Oh, the 10 of Caruso, very high in turn number two, and has looped it onto the infield. Rotten luck there for Stephen Caruso. Did he keep the car going? Of course, these cars, no starter motors. Once they stop, he won't get it refired up without a push start. Looks like he may have got going again, but he's left a big cloud of dust on the infield. Burford will take the win, Hendry second, Cobby third, and then Harold Brennan Jr. rounding out the top four, just ahead of Phil Locke. Ford 10 giving it sprint car title, heat race number four. Jason Johnson on the front row, the American. Dives into turn number one and two, and he'll lead them down the back shoot. Trevor Green in car number 17 in the second spot. Further back there, Ricky Maiolo in car number 24. Good to have him back here at Speedway City after touring with the World Series over the last couple of months. Car diving to the inside there. The 82 of Lee Dillon trying to put the move there. In fact, he may have gone past Sloan, now trying to put the move on the 24 of Ricky Maiolo. Good racing there as Vanderstelt now moving forward here in heat number four as he goes past the 17 of Trevor Green. Green tries to fight back in car 17, and we've got a couple of cars around in turn number two. That may be Ricky Maiolo and also Jamie Stark in the 72. As we go, Green once again. Of course, we've gone back a lap, so Vanderstelt will have to do it all again. Trevor Green's been put back in front of Vanderstelt on the restart. So Green is still second, Vanderstelt third. Jamie Cobby back there in the fourth spot. He has done a lot of laps already tonight in car 97. As we look further back there, one of the cars in a bit of trouble. The leader is still Jason Johnson. There's Vanderstelt in car 21. as Vanderstel got anything for Trevor Green. Have a look at the left rear tyre on Trevor Green's race car. You can see the glowing brake disc on the left rear. Green working the brakes hard, getting the car to steer through the corner with the brakes. Down the back straight away. Vanderstel will be ruining the chance that he had, of course, to get past Green earlier before the early light come out. Cobby's still back there in the fourth spot. Very impressive run from Cobby and also Green. Both these drivers had never sat in these race cars prior to tonight. They've been drafted in to contest the state title. Cobby trying to work the high side on the 21 of Vanderstel. Can't get it to stick. Jason Johnson is driving away with it here in car 5. The Green doing a nice job back there in second. The track's starting to slick off a little bit now. You can see a bit of dust starting to come off these big right rear tyres. And the track's starting to change colour slightly. You can see it's getting a bit shiny in the floodlights. And a bit of rubber being put down as well in turn number 4. Another lap down in the books for Jason Johnson. Good battle there between Lee Dillon and Justin Sloan down there in turn number 1. Checkered flags will be up this time for Jason Johnson. Oh, we've got a car up in smoke and a ball of fire. The 21, I think it is, of Vanderstel was running second. As we see the 17 of Green taking second and also the 97 of Cobby third. So on behalf of the On The Infield...